tell me about the stuff you're working on now that's going to be coming out in the next few months. Or
So, various things. So yesterday we announced, to take a couple of steps back, one of the big things going on in the cross world at the moment is what's called Cross Plus 100, which is an Alan Moore written series. And it's set 100 years after the cross outbreak. So in my slightly wanky elevator pitch kind of way, I would say that it's the first version of post-apocalyptic fiction.
What's that? Sorry, describe that.
Okay, so we're very used to seeing these apocalyptic fictions where the world goes wrong, people are living in the wilderness, dealing with the horror, all the rest of it. Alan's taken that idea and said, all right, well, let's see what happens a century later when people are rebuilding. It is a book about creation rather than a book about destruction. And yes, there's all sorts of horrible stuff that kicks off because it's a cross book, but it's the beauty of it, the thing at the core of it, and I'll come back to why this is so exciting to me in a moment, is that this is the first time in 100 years that people have been able to think not just in terms of survival, not just in terms of fighting back, but genuinely think about stuff that doesn't matter, in particular science fiction and fantasy, and they call it wishful fictions. So the central character is an archivist. She spends her life going to libraries. Yes, she's finding useful technologies and survival mechanisms and things like that, but more importantly, she's just collecting old sci-fi books, because this is the first time in 100 years that anybody's been able to dream and think of weird stuff. So Alan wrote 6 episodes of that, and then he asked me to come and carry on the story, which is what we announced yesterday. So I'm delighted to be continuing that particular mission. So that's one thing. There's a bunch of other stuff with Avatar that I can't really talk about, but really big, important stuff. I'm doing an image book later this year with... Actually, I'm not allowed to talk about that either, but now you know. What else? I'm doing a book with... So I mentioned Six Gun Gorilla earlier on. I'm doing another book through Boom with the same artist, Jeff Stokely, who's one of, in my opinion, the greatest artists out there at the moment. It's called The Spire. That's very cool. That's our... it's our kind of love note to urban crime fantasy, I guess you'd call it. It's the way I pitched it to Jeff was it's Blade Runner meets Dark Crystal, which is kind of all the food groups as far as he's concerned. So that's very cool. Oh God, so many things. I because my brain isn't very good at passing all the stuff on my slate, I ended up writing a list recently so I could have it above my desk, you know, development slate and actual slate. There's something like 9 books on my slate at the moment, and I can't fit them all in my brain at once, so I have to organise it. But yeah, lots of things is the short answer. Yeah, really. And then I've also write prose, so I'm launching my new novella in the next couple of months, going to self-publish that. So yeah, busy boy.
Who do you think is the most inspiration person you've ever worked with?
Alan Moore. Short answer there, but yeah, no, genuine. I mean, it's incredible to be... So, I mean, Garth, for instance, just here, one of my heroes for a long time. Delighted and... disgustingly lucky to be able to say that he's now a close friend, you know, and that's what happens when you enter a tight-knit publishing empire like Avatar. You find yourself working with people you've admired your whole life, and suddenly you're rubbing shoulders with them. And the same is kind of happening with Alan, you know. He's now working almost exclusively for Avatar. He's doing some really exciting projects, and he's kind of bringing the rest of us into the fold. So it's remarkable to have sat down with the great Alan Moore and met him and chatted to him. And it's something I was saying to these guys the other day. When you meet your heroes, it can go one of two ways, right? I mean, we've all heard the story about you should never meet your heroes because they might turn out to be dicks. Not true at all in this case. What happened is there's something to be said for having somebody on a pedestal and you can't approach them. They are an idol that is completely untouchable. And in the case of Alan, for instance, that goes missing when you meet somebody and you get to know them. And I prefer it the way it is. It's far better to be able to be approachable with somebody. But yeah, something does go missing along the way. You no longer have this distant, floating idol. But yeah, that's my answer would be him. Straight away, without a shadow of a doubt. He's the reason I got into comics, and now I'm working with him. And that's the best thing in the world.